Hi there. So here is an extra video regarding on how to set up Luna and Maschine from Native Instruments so that you get all the 16 channels in from Maschine into Luna so that you are able to record the audio individually and not as a stereo bus only. So I will walk you through the steps needed in order to make this configuration happen. So let's get into it. All right. So let's first start from the environment. So what is needed in order to route audio between two different digital audio workstations within Mac is that you do need to have a virtual audio channels or buses to route the audio between. And there are a few software that you can use to do it. And if you happen to have a Pro Tools offers this audio bridge devices that you can route audio between two different digital audio workstations and or a virtual standalone instrument and Pro Tools. Additionally, you can buy things like VB cable. So if we look into what that is, so you have VB audio software from where you can actually buy this virtual audio device. And that enables you to pretty much virtually cable these two things together. So with these two options, you basically are able to then control your audio between two different software. And if you use VP cable, it only has 8 in, 8 outs as a single, so you need to actually buy multiple of them. And then you need to create an aggregate device into which you kind of encapsulate all of these. And then after that, it's pretty much ready to go. But if you happen to have Pro Tools and you have the Pro Tools audio bridge, then you don't need to buy anything extra. There are other software as well that can do that, but I tested few and I found out that if not using Pro Tools, then the VP cable is extremely good one. All right, so what do you need to do? And let's start from Maschine. So in Maschine, I have loaded a sample project, but you need to go into the Maschine settings, and in audio, you need to change the audio device into your bridge device. So now I have actually selected this VP bridge as I created this aggregate device, and it automatically then maps basically the outputs into it so that all the 16 stereo channels get mapped into the 32 mono channels. So that's basically how it works, and then that's one part of it, and then if you look first the audio part, so this is what you need to do in Maschine. Then of course in Maschine also you need to the individual pads, you need to route them. So if you go into the sound into the audio, so the output needs to be routed into external one. This is external 2, external 3, 4, and so on and so forth. And you can change that from here. So instead of going into the group, you need to, of course, map it to go to individual channels as audio output. And that's basically what you need to do on top of the global configuration. You need to map this to the individual channels so that they basically go out from Maschine. Let's go to Luna. So in Luna, in order to do that, you need to go into the settings and you need to go into the hardware, and you need to use Core Audio, because if you use Apollo, you don't see the Core Audio devices. And then you need to enable all of these, like cable A, B, C, and D. And once you have enabled those, then you need to apply that configuration from here. And once you have applied, then you can start mapping those into your audio inputs. So if we look here, what I have done is that for kick, I have taken like that from the cable A. So this is the first second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and so on, so forth channel that comes out. So all the 16 pads have been now mapped. So it's 4x4. And in that sense, it kind of nicely represents also the machine layout. So I have mapped the kick, snare, closed hi-hat, clap, bass is also mapped, and it's in a channel 13. And then, ARP is in channel 14, and harmony is in channel 15, as I have programmed those into these pads, as you can see over here. So that's the audio routing part. But then in order to kind of get the MIDI clock start and stop, you also need to do the following. So you need to see that your IAC driver is enabled, and then you have you can rename that port. So I haven't renamed that as a clock. So you need to enable the IAC driver so that the MIDI can be sent virtually between your digital audio workstation. So here then, if you go into the MIDI settings, you need to go over here and select that the MIDI clock synchronization is enabled for that ICA driver. And then again, if you go into Machina, you need to in the Machina see that when you have the MIDI, it is actually the mode is not internal or off, but it's receive clock. And then you of course need to select from here what clock you want, or what is the input that you want to receive. And once you have done all this, then basically you need to enable the monitoring of all of this, and then of course eventually recording if you want. So when we have everything set up, then we are ready to press play. So let's press play. So as you can see now, the audio is routed from Machina into Luna with individual channels. And those were the tricks that you need to do. Also, you could record it. So let's go over here and basically select everything, and I'll just show that, you know, in principle you can basically get all these let's remove this, and you do need to of course record enable everything, and then you go over here and then you start to record. Alright, so now you have your 8-bar loops here, and then you can basically trim the audio so that they are rightly placed. And as you can see, there is a small delay between Machina and Luna, so you need to basically work a bit with these audio files in order to make sure that they start from 1-1-1, all of them, and the delay is not causing any problems. Of course, that delay could be compensated with the MIDI configuration, but in this case I just showed an example of like how to record between these two, and then utilize these clips in your digital audio workstation. So in this case in Luna. Alrighty, so that is how you integrate Machina into Universal Audio Luna in order to get all the 16 channel out from Machina into Luna so that you can record all the channels individually. If you like the content, remember to subscribe for the channel. Thanks for watching. Bye now.